It's called You're in This Mess the Same as Me. We hope you like it. Assume you're applauding. No, we don't necessarily assume that, but it's good, right? It's good to play. It's really fun. Thank you for attending this. We hope you're enjoying it. We have some green screen technology coming up in a little bit with some guests. We also have some older technology known as the telephone that we're also going to employ pretty soon here. We're going to have some guests via the telephone. That paid good money to shower praise on this release. But before any of those shenanigans, we are going to do... This is the final track on this barely noticeable album that we keep talking about incessantly. I suppose we're going to... This is the night to really, really talk a lot about the barely noticeable album. So if there ever was a night... If there ever was a night or really going to be a night, this will be it. And this is the last track. It's a number called Only in Dreams. Keep Nicely done, you guys. I appreciate that. Yeah, let's hear it again for Paul and John. Oh my gosh, it's such a privilege and a joy for me to be able to play with these guys. It's just so much fun. I tell you.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right. Now we gotta call somebody.
Oh, yeah.
Just decided that we would, just to make it seem at least a little bit more like a show, we would call people just for a little 60-second phone calls. Who am I talking to? I should be talking to you.
I'm looking up.
I think I'm talking to this couch here. But soon I'll be talking to somebody else. I gotta turn the speaker on. Where's Sarah?
Okay, that's on.
And I got a call. I think I'll just start with this fellow. Come on here.
Is this bowling for dollars?
Yeah. You said it, sister.
Oh, he's got a good job.
So, yeah, we are going to try to reach Mr. Brian Ty.
Holy mackerel.
This is just great.
Hello.
Hey, hi, this is John Magnuson calling. Is this Brian Ty?
Hi.
Good. Well, it's so nice of you to actually take my phone call. As we discussed, there was a perceived security threat that you had of me earlier, but we all got over that.
Yeah. So. You finally got me to give you my number.
I don't know what I did to do that. I kind of pleaded with you because this like shtick that we're doing is kind of dependent.
Look at that.
Yeah, I know.
Half my picture.
Yep. it's like a reporter, you know, on the phone when something happens, you know. So, have you been listening to the live stream, or have you just been doing other things?
Yeah. I have. I didn't know that you were into shoegaze and this sort of crazy psychedelic stuff. That was some crazy. Endlessly repeating washes of sound at the beginning there.
Yeah, exactly right. Yeah, right. That was Paul's soul coming out. He couldn't help it. When he gets a spotlight, he has to sort of seize control. You know. So
there's a whole new path for you. I like it.
Yeah, I can't wait to hear that. We'll have to download and make an MP3 of it, make some use of it in some maybe some collaboration project you and I can work on.
Exactly.
Yes. All right. Well, I'd probably spare you, any more of this. But you're such a good sport to take this telephone call. And of course, we wish you were present.
Are there prizes?
No prizes. Although John Sandbo just asked if there are prizes, and I told him no. But now that he's put that thought in everybody's mind, I look like the bad guy. So thanks a lot, John. No. But is Allison there?
She is.
Okay.
She's
right here. Okay. Well, you just tell. I mean, she can come on, but she also we can just say hi to her if that's all.
Okay.
Yeah.
She says hi.
Okay. All right. Good. Well. Yeah.
Is she in a can?
Oh, yeah. There she is. Good. Well, we appreciate that. Yeah, we got over the shoegazing thing, and then I'm glad that it sounds good now. So. All right. Well,
it's beautiful.
Okay. Well, thanks so much for listening. Thanks for saying nice things about the record. You're very nice people, and I appreciate it. We all appreciate it. So, thank you.
It's great work, man.
Okay. Well, thank you so much.
And
we'll talk to you soon.
Bye.
All right. Maybe say something about the green screen. Just because it's looking, Becky's looking like she's really standing here right now, but she's actually in this room to the side, just off to the side of this here. So to be socially distant, we set up a second camera I guess I'm explaining it.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah. It's much better if you okay. do. I would get it so wrong, you know.
I'm far away from yeah. all of you.
I get people just nodding like, okay, sing the next song.
He's in Texas.
Yeah.
See,
is there a drinking game that goes with this live stream? I don't know. That's is it every time there's one of your phone calls?
No, God no.
We should have.
Anyways.
Anyways.
Yes.
Well, that's it. I just wanted to explain
right,
that.
No,
she's
I'm
not
glad
standing
you did.
2 feet away from me. She's actually about 15 feet that direction.
Right, exactly. Becky is actually way over there, but she looked, so it's trickery. So that's how we achieve the distances using green screens. It was Paul's brilliant
Don't
idea.
Don't call the authorities.
Right.
No problems here.
Okay. This is my guitar's in tune. We'll do this next number. This is track number 3 on Barely Noticeable. And it's a collaboration. I wrote someone else's words and I put the music to it. And it is called A Bird That Doesn't Sing. They're too good for me. I'm lucky to have them. And also, how about that Becky Kapell? We didn't even introduce her. We sort of planned that maybe the person who was going to occupy the green screen chamber over there was just going to sneak in while we attempted a phone call. And that's how it happened. And then next thing you know, she was there. We were explaining how she was there. But we never said, did we say it was Becky? Anyways, it's Becky.
It may have been mentioned.
Well,
everybody knows.
It definitely is you. And with that song you sang, I'm going to try to speak with your image. That song, I don't know where you are, but that song you sang with me on the record, and you also sang this one. This is called As Do I. You remember how it goes, don't you, Becky?
I do.
All right. Here it goes.
Said tomorrow, you keep eyes buried below. You continue to put on a show, as do I. Wander around so confused, you despair. struggle is on you now. You keep thinking of that smoldering glow. Tell yourself there must be a way, as do I.
As do I. That was good.
I mean,
I shouldn't just say that was good like that, but I don't mean it to be.
That was really good. We were really good on that
one. Really great. No, I was just pleased with it, that's all. I don't mean to be immodest. It's really very pragmatic. Sometimes it's not good. That was a good one. So thank you, Becky, for helping make it good.
Thank you for writing a good song.
Yeah, right. And now, or thank you, I shouldn't say that either. Right, it's good. No, thank you very much for calling it a good song. this is a good song too that Ray Davies wrote. I think it's credited to Ray and Dave, this one. I've always thought of it as a Dave song. Somebody can chime in with the comments maybe. It's called There's No Life Without Love, right? Was called, and we just always sung it. Tried it one time. She said, Becky said, I can do this. And that's all I needed to know. And yeah, so we'll give it a shot after I get my guitar in tune.
It's pretty close, isn't it, Paul?
It sounds pretty close. So anyways, Becky's going to probably, vamoose maybe after this. So we really appreciate you. Really appreciate you being here, Becky.
I don't know which way to turn to make it.
I don't either.
Yes, John. Exactly. It's been fantastic.
You could just say it to
some
disembodied John voice. Yes, John. No, we really do appreciate you being here, though. It wouldn't have been the same without you. Seriously, it was great. You've been great, so thank you.
Thank you. My first live stream, I think.
Yeah. You're streaming.
Glad I don't have to take care of any business.
Business?
Business.
What do you mean?
The technical side.
Oh, right. I know. Thank God for Paul. Oh, geez. I could never have taken this.
Oh, geez.
We could probably just say that 18 times tonight, but Paul is an all-star.
Ready? For this song?
There is nothing in this life without your love. Julie, oh Julie, there is nothing in this life without your love. There
Screen for their home. It's really fun.
It is, yes. The kids will love it. Okay.
Thanks, though.
Thank you, Becky.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Becky, for coming here and singing. And there you go.
All right. Now. Ooh. Now I think it's time to do that title track. Right?
This is called, this song that we're going to do next is called Barely Noticeable, as is the album. And I don't know what else to say except it wasn't always going to be called Barely Noticeable, but then it just became a light bulb went off. So it's exactly what it should be called. It's kind of funny too, Barely Noticeable. You put out a record called Barely Noticeable, people laugh at that. There's a joke, the joke is part of it. So there you go. I'm just babbling as I tune this guitar.
Where can people buy the record?
They can buy the record. Oh, that's, by the way, I have to get to Hi-Fi. That's where I was going to go, and then I had a flat tire. On Christmas Eve. Now, if that isn't a country song, what is? But I had a flat, so that just spoiled my plan. So anyways, it's not at Hi-Fi yet. I gotta bring that, like, tomorrow. I hope they're open tomorrow. Hope John is open
tomorrow.
That
don't answer my question.
I know. So where it is at, oh, we're gonna, yeah. That's a good lead-in to a call we're gonna make fairly soon. Roadrunner Records, you remember that. You and I went there that one time. There, it's also Down in the Valley. The record, Barely Noticeable, it's there. It's at Barely Brothers. And it is, where else? Where else did I bring it? Oh, No Name. I brought it to No Name. Yeah, and there's one more, and I'm forgetting it.
You can get it online?
Yeah, you can get it at the Bandcamp, you know. And then you can stream it, too, at Spotify, right? That's what they call it. You don't have Spotify. Do you have it? No. Do you have Spotify? You must.
I don't really.
No? Really? You don't really?
Well, I don't
Spotify.
I
see.
I don't listen to it.
Okay, yeah. Anyways, we were just taking a little survey here. all right, so thank you. Yeah, that was good that you asked me. I'm forgetting the one more store, and I'm sorry about that. It'll come to me. Tried to get it to all the stores. Oh, the Electric Fetus, of course. I'm forgetting that. It's there. I know somebody bought it there. So there you go. Alright, yeah. And it's called Barely Noticeable, and this song is also called Barely Noticeable. Actually have to play on, so it's always dangerous when I have to play notes. As Mike knows, we always, Mike Crabtree just is hovering because he's going to he's keeping his distance, and but he's going to occupy the Becky spot pretty soon. So he's right there, and he knows that I always made him play the hard parts.
Let me take your heart, I will come to you. We'll never be apart if I'm part of you. Open up your eyes now, tell me what you see. It is no surprise now, what you see is me. Clouds may be, time will pass away. If you put your trust in me, I'll make bright your day. Look into these eyes now, tell me what you see. It is no surprise now. What you see is me. Tell me what you see. Listen to me one more time.
It's weird, you know. I think you're out there. And I know everybody probably says it. Anyways, we're glad that you're out there, and we hope that you can feel us. We really just enjoy playing. That's the thing. So we really hope you enjoy listening to us, because that makes it that much more fun. So that's the truth. Enough of the mushy stuff. What? Oh, a telephone. Is it telephone time? Yeah. Paul just gave me the universal telephone. So.
Hello.
Oh, hello. How are you? Boy, you're coming in loud and clear, so that's great. So, are you watching the show or the big live stream?
I am, yes.
Good, I'm glad. What do you think? Are we any good tonight?
Yeah, we're having our post-Christmas thing. In front of the fire, mm-hmm. Hanging out, watching live music. You can't beat that.
Oh, sweet. Well, I'm glad. We're glad to be like providing a sort of community service thing, I guess. So, right in your own living room. So.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, so congratulations on this record to you too. And you know, we all should be celebrating it. So we really thank you for making it with me.
It's absolutely been all my pleasure.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. We had a lot of fun. Took a long time, so I'm glad that we liked each other.
It
would have sucked.
It was a great process. I mean, the whole thing was really, it was an exceptional record to make.
Yeah, well, that's good. I'm glad you feel that way. I sure was happy with it and happy with the whole process. So there you go.
Me too.
All right, and I guess, you know, we're going to play with Mike here. Mike Crabtree, you know him, so... he's going to play with us in the next couple songs. I think we'll probably get to that, but I wanted to make sure and make it a painful experience for you and call you up.
Awesome. We'll have fun, you guys.
Okay, thanks so much.
See you, Mark.
All right, see ya.
Bye.
All right. I have to drink a little water, and then we're going to take off with what? The one that's coming up. Guys.
Don't mind if I do.
Yes.
When it came time to choose a single for Barely Noticeable, it was hard to choose. I think that on this record there's kind of folky rock kind of numbers and then country-isher. This is one of the country-isher ones. I had to decide whether I wanted to do the kind of folky thing for a single, country-ish, and we went with this one. And that's all you need to know, I would say. I have to check my tuning, you guys. I'm not sure if it's good. Mike Crabtree is, you can see him now, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
He's right there.
He
yeah. Yeah, right. I can't.
But am I really?
Yeah, right. No, you're not.
I'm not the one.
But Mike and I used to be in the Carpetbaggers together for a long time. And then before that, I knew him. I'd just known him almost my whole life. It's wild. Since third grade. Anyways, there's that. And we live real close to each other. We never see each other, really, but we live close, right? Pardon me?
You did back then, too.
Yeah, right. Exactly. Yeah, right. Exactly. When I first met him, I lived close to him throughout all of high school and everything. And that's about all you need to know about that. All right. We're going to do the single that we put out in advance of the album. And I think I'll take my glasses off. And this is called I Don't Mind If I Do. It's good to have Mike in, however we have him here, whether we beam him in or if you... Mike's one of the good ones, as we all know. Anyone who knows him, he's one of the good ones. I'm looking at him now. I'm enthralled. I can't stop looking at him. He always was. He always told us he was the best looking member of the Carpetbaggers. He always made sure to mention that. Try to incorporate that into some would-be self-deprecating joke. It's not really. You know, it's one of those things. No, I'm kidding. Not at all. But he was the best looking member of the Carpetbaggers. There's no doubt about that.
Now it's silence.
All right, we should do a few more Carpetbaggers in our set, like in general. But we don't do too many, but we do this one, and this is from that band's first record, way back in a year called 1992. And it's called, the song is called Silence.
Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4.
That's Silence. I always tell the joke of perhaps I told it too much, but it was kind of funny to us. Back when we used to play in the Carpetbaggers, somebody out there liked that song, which is great. You know, didn't happen all that much where they like specific songs, but they would scream for it. And like I always think of the Uptown, and they'd go, "Silence!" And we would have to make a joke about that. They're just telling us to shut up, you know, commanding us. But of course, we would make just a joke, and then we'd play the song, because we're not silly. You know? When someone wants to hear your song, you play it. First rule of showbiz, am I right, fellas? That's the end, they know. Just have to wet my whistle with some water, and then we're going to do, Mike's going to play one more, right?
Yeah,
and this is on the record. On the record, I should mention that on the record, the rhythm section on the record is Peter Anderson on the drums and Steve Murray on the bass, yes. And boy, I had a great time with them in the studio. They were excellent. So we just sat down. It was like a fantasy camp for me. They just knew the songs, and they just knew how to play them immediately. It was so great. It was the same experience working with these guys. Well, I'm working on a different record with these fellas. That's how I got to be kind of playing with them a lot. And that same thing happened there. So it just was so painless, you know, just kind of make it happen. So that's lucky for me, is what it is. And so I was going to also mention, so we got Did You Ever Really Go coming up. And on the record of that, Paul Bergen plays really cool guitar, like three guitar tracks and cool solo. But tonight we get Mr. Crabtree's take on it. This is a song we used to do, actually, in the Baggers a million years ago. We never recorded it, though. All right, that's it. That's it. That's all you're going to get out of me about Did You Ever Really Go. But anyways, thank you, Mike, for playing.
Did you go? And I know that you're not here no more. But did you ever, did you go? That's all just your plan. That was on the radio. And I as my finger ready, standing by the door. Slipping in the windows, crash. Did you go? I knew you felt like hell. Did you ever, did you go? I can't fantasize anything. A voice that I don't know. Never had my tongue is twisted up in a crooked bone. I said go to hell. I didn't think he'd really go.
Yes, exactly. That was your little touch. We should mention that it's a certain someone's birthday today. It's John Sandbo's birthday. I keep knowing this, and then I keep not forgetting it, and then like I keep thinking, well, I'm singing a song that I should say something. I'm glad I finally said something. It's not because I don't care about you. I just couldn't remember. I just couldn't remember that. I got a lot on my mind. It's my record release live stream.
Right,
in case you don't know. So.
Third down, Cleveland. No yards.
Yeah, that's right. I don't know if you know. All right. Oh, did Mike leave?
Yeah,
heard, no, I heard him giggle. He's packing up. Anyway, so thanks, Mike.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Mike's going to head out, and then it's just going to be us guys, right? And who we call. We got more calls to make. I wonder who it's going to be. I know who it's going to be. What?
Yeah, I wonder.
I think that's pretty good, but yeah, you're right. Anyways, Paul just said I might want to note the time, and he's right about that. He's right about everything, this guy.
Okay. Should we could do a phone call now, or do you want to do one more song and then a phone call? All right, just like as it's planned. Okay.
This is a song called Suit of Steel, right? Is that what you got next on the list? Okay, Suit of Steel. I think I've mentioned before, and I do tell people that I was going to release two records at the same time. The one I'm making with these guys, and then it's barely noticeable. But then people like Brian Tide, for example, and Annie Fitzgerald told me that wasn't a good idea. And they were right about it, because you want to have things to release, you know, so, multiple things. So why just release it all in one shot? But this is one of the songs that's on that other record, the Paul and John record, as yet unnamed. The song is not unnamed, though. It's called Suit of Steel, and I gotta put the capo on.
Capo.
This song is kind of about how when we sort of become adults, it's really just like years of pretending to be an adult, and then all of a sudden you kind of are one. As opposed to actually becoming an adult, I think it's more just like you sort of pretend to be one until you fooled yourself. So this song is not about that. No, I'm kidding. It is about. It's sort of about that. Suit of Steel. I wear adulthood like a suit of steel. Thank you. all stopped at the same time.
This is Sarah Magnuson.
Hello.
Hello, how are you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
Good. Are you watching this live stream of this hot new band?
Oh, I definitely am. I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Yeah. So my main question, as you know, for you, this is Sarah Magnuson, my daughter. My main question for you is just how well would you say that the record is selling with people your age? You know, I'm assuming that a lot of kids are talking about it in your chat rooms and whatever. So yeah, right? Is that correct?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely. So. I think you're taking the entire pop world by storm.
Wow. Yeah.
You're going to pass Taylor Swift, Ariana Grande, everyone. Wow. You should be very proud of yourself.
Well, I obviously am.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, what choice do I have but to be proud of myself? No, but, well, that's good to hear. And the kids, they like this Americana music, huh? Is that what you're telling me?
Mm-hmm.
They really dig
Definitely.
It? Yeah. Well, I'm surprised to hear that, but I'm glad to hear that. So. Anyways, we just wanted to make sure we checked in and got a take on just what the younger generation thinks of this this bold new music we're trying to put forth, you know. So we appreciate your being kind of a voice for your age group.
Oh yeah, of course.
Yeah. All right. With that, I guess maybe we'll leave you go because we got some more songs to play and our time's gonna run out. So thank you for watching and for actually taking this phone call. I appreciate that. That's very nice.
Of course. Okay. Have fun, you guys.
Okay. Thank you, Sarah.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
What do we have next, fellers?
I trust you.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
All right, next we're going to do I Trust You Burned It. That's track number one on the record. This is a song, actually, sent it to a high school girlfriend just because I liked it. I know I played this song live quite a bit and it got a good response. So I just wanted to share it with her, and I wasn't thinking she would think it had anything to do with her, but she immediately responded, "Oh my God, I'm so sorry!" And receiving, and it really wasn't, I mean, I could totally see how she could mistake it. It was kind of funny, and it was really like this email came right back, like it was like, I was, anyways, I'm in tune now, so I don't have to talk anymore and get myself in trouble. This is called I Trust You Burned It. Sick.
still got it. That's what you said the other day. Yeah.
He still got it.
Yep. I guess it's just apparent. It's readily apparent to all.
All right.
Yeah. So, boy, thank you for those of you who are still out there. We love playing, and we sure hope you're enjoying. Yeah. Really good. I miss it so much. I know everybody does. But the music appreciators and the people who get are lucky enough to play the gigs that we're not playing now. It's really gutting people in all sorts of ways. So this is nice. So thanks for being here. Really appreciate it. And that record is barely noticeable. I have a website, johnmagnusonmusic.com. You can kind of start there if you ever want to. Try to get the record, and it's also available at stores. I strongly recommend you go check our records, great record stores that we have in town here, Roadrunner, Electric Fetus, No Name to Name, just a few, and also Hi-Fi, and the list goes on. I'm just going to leave people out. But there are great stores, and they have copies of this, and they got copies of lots of great local artists. So check out these stores. Seriously. And now we have to, or not have to, we get to do another song, actually, from the record that I'm making with Paul McFarland here, and he's going to sing with me on this one.
What?
Oh. Yeah. Is that right? Sure. Going to get going. This is a song that kind of starts with an analogy of, like, if you keep loving someone after a breakup, as makes an analogy that to the hair growing on a corpse after the person dies. That was the jumping off point for this song, and it goes a little something like this, with featuring Paul McFarland on harmony.
Plant a hair on the head of a corpse. Love kept on growing long after divorce. Just like the hair on the pillow right next to his head. One day it fell out of love and I was dead. You're gone, and now I think I'm gonna get going too. You're gone, and now I think I'm gonna get good. Back the good suit in which she is dressed. Thank you. nobody to notice or care. You're gone, and now I think I'm gonna get good too. You're gone, and now I think I'm gonna get good too.
That deserves like the Muppet nod, you know, when they would finish the song and the canned audience would go and all the puppets would nod and say, nice job. Yeah, that's what I feel. That's something to aspire to.
Yeah.
See a couple more, huh?
Just a couple, yeah. All right. We should do... let's do I Stand Correct.
Yeah, okay.
Is that right?
Yeah.
And then finish with the Tommy Collins.
Yeah, I like it.
All right.
Which one?
I Stand Corrected.
Okay.
This is track number 2. For those of you still with us, we're just, I think our end time is, we're looking at the old clock on the wall. And it's getting close to the end, so I think I better shut up if we're going to get 2 songs in. This is track number 2 of the record called I Stand Corrected. I Stand Corrected, I Sit Corrected, and I Walk with a Limp.
Is fair, cards are marked in print. Was a horse so sure of the benevolence of pips? I stand corrected, I sit corrected, but oh, lip I stand corrected. Still I sink into the sand, I stand corrected. Still I don't know where I stand, I sit corrected. But one makes sure the rest along all these corrections. I did so much and time seems wrong.
That was what we did wrong. It was our first mistake. We tried to work on that. And let this be a lesson to you kids. Okay, I think we got to do this one, and then we got to be done. But we really appreciate you listening.
And we'll end with this Tommy Collins song. I don't know if you know him. He's a country guy, came before Buck Owens. Buck played guitar for him, actually. And Tommy's great, and it's called I'll Never Ever Let You Go. Thanks again, John Magnuson, barely noticeable. This is Paul McFarland and John Sandbo. And we really appreciate everything. Thank you.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Since I met you, I've been so in love with you. Can't forget you, dear, no matter what I do. I would love to hear you say that I'm your Sandbo. I've never been so much in love with anyone. You say that I'm the only one. And if I ever get you, I'll never ever let you go. If I knew that you were only being sure, all this waiting would be easy to endure. But I'm afraid that you will find somebody else. You're the only one I love, you know. If you do decide to take a chance with me, I won't be foolish, I'll be good as I can be. And if I ever get you, I'll never ever let you go.
It was great. Thank you.